Okay, in reality, no data are directly transported from the layer n on one machine to the layer n on another machine. Instead, each layer passes the data and the control information to the layer immediately below it until the information has reached to the lower layer. So below the lower layer is the physical media. So here it is, a layer one is the physical media. It is responsible for conversion of these particular bits into the signals and make them to propagate through the physical media, and this information is transmitted to the layer n of another machine, that is a destination machine, and these signals are once again converted into the bits, and once again the information is transmitted up to the upper layers. Now here you are going to be see the example of one a layered network system. So below you are having the hardwares will be there, and that upper layer is a host to host connectivity will be there, and the next one is a process to process channels are going to be available. So through these channels, that is a process to process is going to be communicating, that is the process running on one machine is able to communicate with the process running on another machine on the network, and above that we are having a different application programs. Now the process to process channels, you are having two types of channels are there. One is a request reply channel, another one is a message stream channel will be there. Now if you are going to see the protocol graph, how exactly it looks like, so you are having a different types of the applications are there which are running on the machines. Say for example, a machine where application like file application is running, digital library application is running, video applications are running. So the file applications and digital library applications, as I've discussed already, they are going to be required request reply protocol, and video applications, video on demand, video conferencing, these are all the applications which are going to be required a message stream channel, that is the message stream protocol. Now the information which is going to be transmitted by these particular file applications and all, it is going to be transmitted to the below mentioned channels. So here it is that an application program is going to generate the data. That data is going to be transmitted to the RRP, that is a request reply protocol, and then it is going to encapsulate the data, then it is going to be attach a header of that particular RRP, and this layer is going to be send the information to the HHP. The HHP is going to not bother about what type of information is present in this, simply it is going to receive the information and it is going to be encapsulate the information and put it into the another one, that a particular the packet, it is going to attach the header as a HHP, and this completely is going to be transmitted to the network, and on the receiving machine is going to receive this the complete whole packet. The HHP which is present on the receiver side, that is a host to host protocol, is going to see that particular header. So it is going to remove that header, and inside that the content, the packet, whatever is there, it is going to be transmitted to the RRP. Now the RRP is going to, the request reply protocol running on the receiving machine is going to receive that, it is going to see the header, and then inside that whatever the data is there, data is going to be transmitted to the application program. Now here it is that each one is going to attach the header and a tailor. Okay, so why we need the header and the tailor? Now the headers are usually attached to the front of the message, that is in some cases the peer-to-peer control information is sent at the end of the message. So in each case it is called as a trailer. So we said that the application data is encapsulated in the new message created by the protocol RRP. This process of encapsulation is repeated at each level of the protocol graph, that is in the HHP encapsulate the RRP message by attaching a header of its particular own. Now the attachment of this particular header and the trailer is going to give you the clear information to the receiver side, that a particular the peer protocol, that how to handle this particular the message. Okay, so here it is that which takes what action is indicated by the RRP, the header that its peer attached, and passes the body of the message up to the application program. The message passed up by the RRP to the application is exactly the same message as the application one passed down to the RRP on the host one. Okay, so this is how your information is going to be transmitted. So now you are going to see that how the encapsulation process is done. So here it is, a message will be there which is going to be generated. That message is going to be attached to the header, that is here it is a H4, and it is, if it is, the message is larger, you are going to break into the smaller segments. Each segments you are going to be attaching a particular the header, and it is going to be transmitted to the below layers, and below layer that message is going to be encapsulated, and each one is going to be assigning the header, and then it is transmitted from source machine to the destination machine. Okay, so this is how you are going to send the information from one computer to another computer using the layered architecture. So first we have to identify what are all the tasks are going to be required, identify how many number of layers are going to be required, assign the name to each particular layer, assign the task to each particular layer, and the task should be assigned in a particular order. The information has to be flow from either top to the bottom, or either it may be flow from bottom to the top layer. So in this way, here we are going to transfer the information in the layered approach. Now we are going to see about this layered approach only. So in this layered approach, we are going to see one of the architecture. So this architecture, we are going to be call it as a 7 layers of the ISO OSI model. So this is a one of the model where we are having a 7 layers are there. So that is, the first one is a physical layer, data link layer, network layer, transport layer, session layer, presentation layer, and a application layer. That is the ISO OSI model. It was established in the 1947, the International Standards Organization ISO. It is a multinational body dedicated to worldwide agreement on international standards. So what do you mean by this ISO OSI model? ISO OSI model is an international standard organization. The OSI is at the open system interconnection. What do you mean by open system? There are two types of systems are there. One is a closed system, another one is a open system. The system which is going to be closed, it is not going to be interact with the outside world. It is not going to be send and receive any particular information. A system which is open, if it is open, it has to be connected to the network, and it is able to send and receive the information to its outside world. Now, the systems which are open, the systems which are wanted to communicate with the outside world, how they have to send the information from one computer to the another computer using this particular the network. So this is the model. It is going to be defined that the work, the task, whatever is going to be carried out to transfer the information from one computer to the another computer. So here in this, the ISO OSI model, that is the open system interconnection model, so these 7 layers are there. So as here you are going to see that each layer is going to perform some particular the task. Now you are going to be say that device A want to send the information to the device B. In between you are having a networks. So in this example here, they have been shown the two different routers. This is the intermediate routers are there. Now here device A, where all the 7 layers are going to be running, and in the device B also all the 7 layers are going to be running. That is the peer-to-peer protocol, that is application layer present on the device A should be able to communicate with the application layer on the receiving device. So that's why, as I've already discussed about, that is a peer-to-peer protocol should be present, that how the communication should takes place between these peer layers. Now the presentation layer present on the device A is able to communicate with the presentation layer on the device B, but there is no direct communication between the application layer on the device A to the application layer present on the device B. The information has to be transmitted from application layer to the presentation layer, from to the session layer, up to the physical layer. Now physical layer is responsible for conversion of these particular bits into the signals, make them to propagate through the network, and in between you are having the routers are there. In each router, 3 layers are going to be executing, that is a network layer, data link layer, and a physical layer. Okay, you remember that each host should run all the 7 layers. In between the routers should run 3 layers, that is a network, data, and a physical layers. So all they are going to receive that particular information, they are going to forward it until it reaches the destination machine. When it reaches the destination machine, so here it is a device B. So the physical layer of the device B is going to receive that information. Now that information is transmitted from physical to the upper layer, data link layer, network layer, transport, session, presentation, and the application which is running on the device B, it is going to receive the message. Now this is the same message which is transmitted by the application running on the device A. Now it is received by the application which is running on the device B. Okay, so each layer you are having the interfaces are there. How exactly one layer is going to provide a service to the another layer? So here you are going to be see that and exchanging using the OSI model. So the device A is going to sending the information, that is the D7 is the data and header is going to be attached. That information is transmitted to the below layer. It is going to be completely encapsulated inside that particular packet. And the second layer is going to attach the header. So here H6 is the header which is going to be attached. And similarly, you are going to be see that how each one layer is going to be encapsulating the message which is received from its upper layer. The last one layer is the physical layer. You are going to say that in the physical layer, they are shown the combinations of zeros and ones. So first is a header and these are all the bits of the header. And here it is the encapsulated message which is received from the upper one. These bits are now converted into the signals and make them to propagate to the transmission media. Through this transmission media, these digital signals are going to be transmitting, and in the receiving machine, these bits are going to be received. Once the bits are received, now it are going to see that what they have to do with this particular message. Header is there. By seeing the header, it will come to know that how to handle this particular message. And by knowing this, inside that, whatever the message is, this is transmitted to its upper layer, that is the D2. Now header is there. So the header is transmitted by its peer layer, which is present on the sender machine. So in the similarly, each one is going to see the header. They will come to know what to do with this particular message, how to handle. Each one is going to remove that. Inside that, whatever the message is, it is transmitted to the upper layers. Now if you are going to see that the upper layer, the topmost layer, is going to receive the message, that is the D7, which is transmitted by the H7 of the host one. It is received by the H7 layer of the receiving machine, that is a destination machine. So it is just like that, encapsulating one packet inside another one packet. Each layer doesn't know what information is presented inside. Simply they are going to forward or process that information to move from one layer to the another layer and make them to propagate to the physical media, and the reverse process is done on the receiving side. Okay, so now we are going to see about what is the work done by each particular layers. Okay, so we'll stop it here, and next we will see the work done by each particular layers.